pursuing a 4-1 defeat. How do you explain such a capitulation at the end of that first half?
Well, we certainly can't make any excuses. We couldn't have started the game any better in that first 25 minutes. Team away from home, I thought we were excellent. Got the goal, could have got a second one. But in a 15-minute period, we've lost the game. And even at 2-1, we've given away two goals that are basic goals against a player that you know is physically very, very strong. And you have to better match that one. And we didn't. In them two goals, but at that stage we have to make sure that we gather as a team, and we have to make sure that we dig deep as a team, and at 2-1 it still allows us to get back in the game. But over a 15 minute period we were nowhere near good enough. We couldn't cope with the power and pace that they had, and ultimately that's lost us the game.
And the game was gone, wasn't it? I mean, I don't know, what do you say at half time to a team that's 4-1 down?
At half time, it's just about pride, that's all. It's about pride and keeping a clean sheet in that second half. And that's all it can be about, because it's a 15 minute period in that first half that's lost us the game. And for anybody seeing the game, as I say, for a team away from home, we couldn't have started the game any brighter, particularly here. Kept the crowd quiet. We know what the crowd can be like here once they get behind you. But we have analysed the goals, and you know, we've conceded poor goals over that period. And you can't afford to do that, not anywhere, let alone here.
You brought on Johan Almander in the second half. He's a striker, but you played him on the right wing. What was the thinking there?
The thinking there was that we had to consolidate. At half-time, can you get back in the game? You'd like to think so, but it makes it very, very, very difficult. We had to make sure that we're consolidating, that we weren't conceding anymore, but also to give us a little bit of a chance on the set plays, give us a bit of a chance from Johan breaking from a wide area to get back into the game. You know, on any way that you are prepared to open up against these and against what we saw in that last 15 minutes of the first half, then, you know, they've got the ammunition to hurt you even more. You need to have a base to try and get back in the game, but you know it's going to be very difficult.
Clean sheets against Tottenham, against Manchester City recently, and then you see that today. That as a manager, are you not quite sure what you're going to get for your team when you send them out at the moment?
What I thought I was going to get was what we've got in recent weeks, and that's the form that we've showed. We've certainly become more resilient, you know, over this latter part of the season, but that's a huge blow back for us. You know, we've looked solid at the back. The manner in which we've conceded the goals is, of course, a concern. We are up against a top-class striker when he's in that type of mood, and we found it difficult to contain him today.
You've said in the past that you and the chief executive are singing from the same hymn sheet. You're on the same side. Is it going to be difficult to face him after that?
It's part and parcel of the game. It's the highs of the game. At this moment, it's a particular low, because I'm speaking to you some, whatever, 45 minutes after the result. So at the moment, we're all hurting. We're all embarrassed by the performance, or we're embarrassed by a 15-minute performance in that first half. There's nobody that takes it or has to take it on the chin more than myself. It's my responsibility on the manager's football club. At this moment, it's a bad feeling, because we haven't done well enough today. And it's a difficult week, because the players all, I think we have some 9 players that will be going away on international duty, and we won't see them again until Thursday. But we have a home game to prepare for now on Saturday, and we're going to need to be far better than what we were today, and we're going to need to be can have everybody behind us.
And just a quick injury bulletin: Leroy Fair, we knew, wasn't going to play today. Ricky van Wolfsmichel out as well. Can you put a time frame on those two?
Ricky's was minor. He took a whack in the Tottenham game last weekend. We felt he would recover, but he hasn't done so. He's minimal. We're still assessing Leroy, but at this moment he does have a hamstring pull.
Missed him today, didn't he? His influence, his energy in midfield.
Well, I think we missed him today, because he's a player that has got better as the season's gone on, and in particular the last few games he's played very well. So yes, we did miss him today, but at some stage, once we reflect on this one, we're going to have to put it behind us and make sure that we rally everybody for what will be a tough game at home to Stoke on Saturday.